What's up? How are you guys doing? Yeah? All right, nice. First of all, sorry for the delay, but there are a lot of people talking to a lot of other people in the exhibition area, so we were just waiting for people to sort of come in. I wanted to do a quick show of hands before we begin. For how many of you is this the first CloudBazaar that you're visiting? The first ever CloudBazaar? Okay, wow. There's so many new entrants, huh? How many of you guys have been here around for multiple years? Yeah, right? See, there are a lot of hands for that as well. So this is really what CloudBazaar is all about, right? I mean, since we started today morning, I've met so many people who've been here for so many years, who've been coming back every year. And when we had started this event, the idea was very simple. How is it that we can add more value for our web professional partners, for our web hosting partners, and how is it that we can help them drive better business, right? We started off, I think it was way back in 2012, and you know, we've been going at this year on year, maybe different names, etc. But this has been one of the best things or one of the best experiences for us, right? Every year, the entire team looks forward to this event, looks forward to making sure that they can come here and meet with you guys and talk with you guys and really try and make sure that, you know, you all derive value out of this entire event, right? Do you guys know what I do for those who've come for my sessions in the past? Do you know what I do at the beginning of my sessions? Can anybody tell me? No? Okay, I thank people. I'd like to start off with those thank yous before I move ahead. Thank you to the CloudBazaar team for putting everything together. I can see that there are a lot of people engaged outside, so you haven't managed to get enough people for my session, but that's fine. But thank you to the CloudBazaar team, all right? Thanks to the Reseller Club team. We've been preparing this for several months now, making sure that every single thing works brilliantly. We've been making sure that we're giving the right information, we're talking to our customers, taking feedback from them for this event, for how we can sort of improve it. Thank you to the Reseller Club team as well. Thank you to all our partners, without whom we can't really do this event because, you know, it's expensive otherwise. So thank you for coming in and partnering with us and talking to all our customers, you know, all our web professionals. And last but not the least, thank you to the team over here or to the partners over here that we've got, all our clients, all our customers, all our web professionals, web hosts, etc. I'd like to start off by, first of all, you guys giving a huge round of applause to yourselves. Thank you for being you and for being India's entire sort of, you know, core fundamentals behind which, you know, everybody's online presence works, right? So India's SMB problem is India's SMB opportunity. Every year when we come in, right, when we start talking about, or when I start giving a presentation, like I said, the main idea is that how can I give you guys information that is useful, that is valuable, that can help you all do your business better, that probably gives you all a newer perspective. This year what we've done is, I've actually sort of made this presentation into an amalgamation of a lot of my previous talks, right? Because in the past, I have spoken to you guys about this market, about how it's moving. For the last 2 or 3 years at various different conferences, we've spoken about how there is some amount of a shift that's taking place in the market. Well, guess what? That shift that was taking place, that shift has taken place now, right? And now that that shift has taken place, some of you have already sort of adapted, right? But what can we do to be able to continue to evolve ourselves and make sure that we continue adding value to all the SMBs that exist that want to get online, right? So this presentation covers a couple of challenges. I think problems, while it's an aggressive word, you know, these are challenges today. And then a few ideas on how to overcome those challenges and really try and excel and grow your business. Make sense? Yeah? Okay, all right. So I'm gonna move ahead once I figure out how to. Okay. So, what is the problem? Do any of you guys want to take a stab at what the problem might be? Anybody, just scream out an answer. What is the problem that we see with SMBs today? Okay, I will continue. Now, there are 51 million SMBs in India. There are 15 million that are online. Out of those 15 million that are online, there are only 3 million that actually have websites registered or created, all right, as Indian customers. Okay, so where are the rest of them going? They are going to what we would otherwise call an alternative online presence. Right? An alternative online presence could be social media pages like Facebook business pages, aggregators like Just Dial, Zomato, etc. They're going to marketplaces like Amazon, Flipkart, etc. All right? So what we're essentially saying, and by the way, all this data that I'm sharing with you is data that has been collected from 73 to 74 different website stories and a few reports by Zinnov, by KPMG and Google. So this is a lot of data that I've put together, and I'm only sort of going to present some of the highlights to you, right? But this is all data points that is being presented by other third parties, authoritative figures, and by customers that we're talking to as well, right? So there's a little bit of qualitative and a little bit of quantitative study in this data, right? But 15 million SMBs are online. 3 million have websites. The rest use an alternative presence. Now you tell me, all right, if 4x of the number of websites that exist today are an alternative online presence, then how is that an alternative online presence? It today is becoming a fact that websites is actually the alternative presence now, because if your majority of your customers, if 80% of your customers have an online presence but don't have a website, then what is the alternative presence? The alternative presence is a website. Oh, I think I moved. How do I? So in this presentation, while I talk about websites, or while Reseller Club largely deals with websites, I know my web professionals do a lot more, right? So I'm also going to talk a little bit about applications, about custom developed applications. How many of you guys, quick show of hands, build applications for your clients? Yeah, exactly, right? So what about applications today, right? There are so many different SaaS applications that are out in the market that to a large extent are stagnating the growth of custom app development as well. Because a lot of people today end up moving to the Zohos of the world, the Salesforces of the world, and a lot of other SaaS providers, right? So basically, we talk about growth in digital adoption, right? And there are stats which I haven't put over here because I've spoken about them a bunch of times in the past. But we say that the growth of digital adoption in India is on the rise, and how? What does that mean? That means that the number of internet users you have in the country, more than 450 million, right? The number of people that are transacting online, that are purchasing online, purchasing through mobile phones, etc., has gone off the roof. But do you see the same sort of growth when it comes to your customers or potential customers going online and setting up an online presence? Now, a lot of you guys might say that, look, I have a lot of customers, I'm fine. Right? But the fact of the matter is that in this market today, the potential is a lot more. There could be many, many more web professionals servicing this market if required, right? But the fact is that the market is moving in a slightly different direction. So the definition of an online presence, like I was telling you earlier, is evolving, right? I don't think you can call Facebook business pages an alternative online presence anymore. I don't think you can do that for the all the different aggregators that exist as well. There's an aggregator for every single industry, for every single type of industry that exists, when it, you know, whether it be restaurants, whether it be chemical companies, whatever it might be, right? And your customers are making their preference or what they want to do, how they want to be online, pretty clear with the statistics that we just saw, right? But this is only the beginning, right? So when I say that this is a problem, I'm saying that this is a challenge or a problem from your perspective, from the web professional's perspective, right? For a lot of registrars, web hosting providers, etc., it might be easy because that means that more customers are actually buying directly, right? So if you're not servicing websites, if you're not building custom applications, then what does that mean for our future? What does that mean for this industry, for the web professionals, for everybody out here? How many of you guys, how much of this is resonating with you guys? Yeah? Quick show of hands. Does this resonate? Yeah, right? So on both these aspects, around websites and around applications, I'm just going to do a slightly deeper dive, all right? So the website problem, like I said, there are 51 million SMBs that exist, okay? 68% have no sort of online presence whatsoever, all right? Nothing, nada, zip, zilch, big goose egg. The remaining 32%, all right, out of those 32%, 24%, have an online presence, not including a website, all right? 6% have some sort of a basic online presence, and about 2%, roughly around 2% or lesser, have some sort of e-commerce solution added to their online presence. Now, the interesting thing is that this is what we hear from customers and from SMBs. It's in your, on your screens. Can you guys see this? Yeah, people at the back? Yeah? Nahi dikh raha to aa gaya ho na? No? Okay. So a website does not add value to my business. How many of you guys have heard this statement? Right? It's too expensive. Haan toh discount do na phir. I don't know too many good designers, developers around me. Now this, you know, we are sitting in Bombay. There are a lot of people that have come from other cities as well. This actually surprised me as well. This was in one of the reports that I was checking. But a lot of people in tier three cities, in towns, etc., actually believe this. They believe that they don't have the right infrastructure or the right kind of people to be able to help them get online as well. Right? So it seems like a lot of the influencers, a lot of the web professionals tend to do business, and rightly so, in tier one, tier two cities, etc. But this part of the market, your tier three cities, etc., seems to be fairly underserved. Now the application problem. This is interesting, right? There are various reports that you'll read about how the cloud market in India is booming. There are, you know, it's going to reach $4.1 billion in 2020 itself, right? Now, of all the people that have built custom applications, maybe through you guys, maybe through other guys, all right, 24% of them, according to some of our studies, have actually let go of what they've built, all right, and moved on to other SaaS applications. And this is in the last 2 years alone, 24%. All right, that's huge. And I'm not even talking about the new entrants, the new people that really want to set up some sort of software to run their business, whether it be inventory management, whether it be a CRM, whether it be some sort of an accounting tool or an HR and payroll tool. The new entrants, forget you know, how many new people are coming in. 24% of your existing audience has moved into some of these cloud-based solutions. So custom development in many ways is declining, right? And this is what customers say when it comes to custom development. How much of this resonates with you guys? How many people find it too expensive to spend a lot of money initially, even though it saves them money later? Yeah? Yeah? Okay. They're saying that apps on the public cloud are fast and flexible, right? They're saying that they're more confident about the security that exists on the public cloud today, right? These are some of the factors that are influencing them to move to ready-made solutions. So basically, SMBs don't always want websites or custom developed apps. So now what to do? Does anybody want to answer that? Okay. Look, like I said, for the last 2 or 3 years, I have been beating these drums, talking about how people are moving to these various different avenues and sort of doing business in a different way, right? We've been living through this extremely critical junction, okay? Or this is that junction where you decide, how do I now do my business, all right? I'm going to get customers in, they're going to come in, but are they going to dry up? And how do I make sure that I sustain myself over a period of time? So the only way forward is to really adapt and evolve. And when the slide changes, I will tell you now things that I haven't mentioned yet about SMBs. I mentioned a bunch of things, but these are some more things that you need to sort of know, right? So do you agree that for an SMB or for your customers, the biggest thing for them is that they want to grow their business? That's all they care about. They don't really care about the online presence. They're just saying, I want to grow my business. Agreed? Can I hear a yes from everybody if you agree? Okay, cool. Haan, yaar, wake up, na little coffee chahiye kya? Yes. Okay, so now, if that is one, that is their number one priority, that they want to grow their business. While I have been talking about a lot of DIY ways in which customers are going online, right? Like, you don't need a web professional to really probably help you get online with a Facebook business page or set up an application or something like this, right? Today, people are getting more tech savvy also. But the truth is that India is this market which may have been a completely do-it-for-me or a DIFM market at one point in time. It is not really a DIY market either. It is actually somewhere in the middle. So even if I am trying to basically set up something on a Facebook business page, I still want to consult somebody who knows how to do that. How many of you guys agree with that? Exactly, right? I still want somebody who can help me set up my software, even if I've basically bought a ready-made one, right? So it's India is a market that is probably buying more DIY products, but still asking people to do it for them or asking people to help them sort of set it up. Agreed? So that's good, no? All right, so we've established what SMBs do. We've established how, you know, there are trends which are taking place in the market, which are making the market move in a certain way, but it's still somewhere that basically sits in the middle of a DIY and a DIFM market, right? Now, before I move ahead in terms of what we could do, I'd like to understand more of what you already do, okay? So who are you, right? What are the services that you offer? Quick show of hands as to how many people offer web design services. Okay, how many people offer custom development applications? Okay, how many of you guys offer marketing promotions and, you know, online promotions, etc., for your customers? Great. How many of you guys offer designing of other material other than just websites, like maybe logos, maybe banners, etc.? Great. So a lot of you guys do a bunch of these things, right? Right? Great. How many of you guys also offer IT management, which basically means taking a lot of these DIY products and managing it for your customers? Quick show of hands. Right, so by the way, just you guys might not have seen this, but for the last question, we had the least amount of hands up, and I'll come to that in a bit, right? So these are typical services that are offered today by you guys that are offered for customers. Just take a look at it. Do you guys largely agree with this? Yeah? Yes? Okay. So these are the various services that you offer. And what should you now go ahead and offer? Does anybody have any? Sorry? You want to go back to the earlier slide? I'll come back to that in a second. You'll see it again. Don't worry. Okay. Do you have any suggestions in terms of what you should offer? Hannah, because I covered a lot of it, so now what to offer? The point is to offer all of it. And this is the same slide with a different title. No, I wasn't being lazy. I was just trying to make a point. But the idea is that as a web professional today, right, you can't stick to just one kind of specialization. You have to try and make sure that you offer as many different services as possible for your existing customers. That means that they get access to a lot more. All right, for new customers, they could enter the door through various different services. It's not necessarily like all of them are just looking for the same thing. All right, so you have to make sure that you offer every single one of these services in one way or another. It is becoming extremely important that you do, right? Today, when you look at the market, when you look at, you know, how this market is evolving, all right, if websites are not growing fast enough, if custom development is stagnating, it makes sense to make sure that you're actually, you know, keeping your fingers in each one of these buckets, right? Partner if you don't provide. So if you cannot provide all of these services, find somebody else who specializes in other products which don't compete with you and try to partner with them. Okay, that partnership doesn't need to be a merger of any kind, but that means that when you get a customer, don't send him away, send him to your partner or represent your partner and service him. Does that make sense? How many of you guys try and do that? Exactly. Reuse what you build. How many of you guys build custom apps and then try to sell them as products? Right? Why not? If you're building an application for somebody, you've identified a use case. As unique as your customer might think his use case is, it's not. There will always be takers for the same kind of use cases. So if something is built, why not actually try and offer it to more people? Set yourself up on, you know, the Amazon marketplace, on other marketplaces, etc. One long-standing goal that we have as well at Reseller Club is to actually allow for our web professionals to put their applications on our platform so that we can offer it to other web professionals for their customers as well. That won't happen anytime soon, don't get me wrong, but it is a goal that we hope to achieve over a period of time. Make sense so far? Yeah? Okay. Now, understand this, your product offering is only half the battle, right? Even if you've got all these products and services, it's not going to be enough if you don't know who you're targeting and if you don't know how to sort of get to that target market, right? So now everybody has their own targets or has their own specific people that they are confident about targeting. And I completely respect that, right? Some people might specialize in a particular vertical. Some people might say, just bring on the customers, I'll handle all of them. I agree with all those perspectives. I just feel what I've listed down over here are some relatively untapped sectors that we've not gone out and approached to a large extent, right? So the handicrafts industries or other cottage industries, they are fairly underserved because a lot of them, all right, are only now recognizing what an online presence can do for them. A lot of these guys are probably already on portals or on aggregators, right? But they don't have full-fledged websites. They have great value in selling their products all over India or maybe even outside of India because they make interesting stuff. People want to buy their stuff, right? But they don't always have the right representation from web professionals to be able to help them do that, right? Startups. As much as we believe that startups are pretty tech-savvy, etc., while they are, you have no idea how many startups today cannot afford to get a designer full-time to be able to manage their site, etc. A lot of this work is typically outsourced. How many of you guys actually target startups today? There you go. Works for you guys, whoever put your hands up? Exactly, right? So more and more of you should try and target startups. And I'm not trying to cannibalize anybody's business. I'm just saying that there's a huge market out there to sort of try and capture. other artists like painters, musicians, etc. These guys want to get online, want to make sure that their profiles look good, they look professional, etc. And there's a lot of stuff that can be done around this vertical as well. Professionals like doctors, lawyers. How many of you guys target doctors, lawyers? Right? Okay, so a bunch of you guys. So I always used to think that targeting doctors, lawyers, and other professionals, they'll be like, no, let me just do my work. I'm getting word of mouth. I'm happy with that. Right? You'll be surprised to know how particular some of these guys get about their website, how particular some of these guys get about what applications they're using. My sister is a lawyer. She works in a startup law firm. And it's been insane. I was speaking to them about how they were talking about how they've been managing everything through Excel sheets. And when we started talking to them about applications that they could use, etc., I mean, they've gone all out. They've ended up getting 3 or 4 different applications, including an ERP. They will do that. They invest as long as they see value, right? And tier 3 cities and other towns, like I told you guys earlier, those markets seem to be relatively underserved. That is definitely something that you should look at exploring as well. Make sense so far? Yeah. Are there any other verticals that anybody wants to call out that are interesting? No? Should I move on? Don't want to share. Okay. Fair? Fair? So, one thing to know your target. The other thing to know is that when you're going to your target, how do you position yourselves, right? In this market, I'll tell you one thing that I've heard from a lot of different customers, okay? They always feel that they are being overcharged. How many of you guys agree with that? Right? Always believe they are being overcharged, all right? So it's very important that when you go to them, right, you are in a position where you've established some amount of trust, or you establish that trust while you sort of work with them, etc., right? So to do that, first of all, you need to be this all-in-one store, which I've already covered, all right? Two, you need to make sure that your belief, your internal belief, all right, and what you communicate to your customers is not that I'm doing a service for you, but I want to add value to your business, all right? You guys are not people who just basically do a job and leave it over there. What you all do is add a continuous amount of value to somebody's business. And if that's the approach that you take, right, it's going to actually help you grow your business, because customers can see that. If you actually believe that and communicate accordingly, customers will see that, right? But it has to start with you knowing that your job for these guys, or your task, is to add value, right? And be thought leaders. Make sure that when you address customers, when you talk to your customers, they understand that value. They understand how having an online presence helps people. And these are facts, okay? It helps people employ 5x the number of people that don't have websites or are not online. It helps people grow revenues and profits by 2x compared to those that are offline. And it helps people actually interact with customers outside their cities, right? So more than 50% of people that have websites in India are people that actually have a customer base which is outside their city, right? Those are very interesting items for SMBs to know from you guys. They're not reading these reports. These reports are being read by idiots like me and being passed on to you guys, who now need to take it and go to these guys. Agreed? Yeah? Okay. Marketing yourself. We spoke about a bunch of things that, as services that you want to offer, or that you already offer to your customers, all right? You need to make sure you use all of them as well. Whether it be email marketing, SEO, SEM, all of this makes a lot of sense for you guys to use when it comes to promoting your business, right? Over and above this, it's extremely important to have really good, meaningful content. Now, that content could be around the merits of being online, like I just mentioned to you guys. It could be about, better design practices, because that, again, helps you be a thought leader and people understand why you're charging what you are, all right? And make sure that all of this information is being covered in seminars, conferences, on your blog, right? And obviously, you need to also make sure that your services are promoted on portals like Fiverr. How many of you guys are listed on Fiverr? Right? I don't know if it specifically helps you guys, but there are several other portals out there, and sort of making sure that you're on those portals will automatically get you more customers as well. Any other marketing pieces? Or okay, we're not sharing. Right. Now, while we talk about your positioning, while we talk about how you can sort of market yourself, what products you can offer, who you should offer it to, this is stuff that I'd covered last time. And like I told you, this is an amalgamation of like probably 7 years worth of presentations. But none of this is actually possible if you don't have the right fundamentals in the business that you run, right? It's extremely important that you have a clear-cut vision, all right? You define it. Put it down in words, put it down in two sentences, that this is what I want to basically make sure that every doctor that basically has an online presence is getting it from me. That's a clear-cut vision as well. It might be one statement, it might be five statements, but make sure it's drafted and communicated clearly, right, to your company internally and then externally, right? Make sure that you build the right team composition. Like I said, you don't need to have specialists for all the different types of services that you're offering. You could partner with people as well, but make sure that the most important ones are there and you've got the right sort of composition for that, and that they are actually the best that you can get, right? Make sure that you're hiring the best, you're maintaining the right work culture, you're investing in their training, in their learning. And by the way, a lot of companies say that, you know, we train people and then they leave. That's not necessary. The more you invest in training, the more they'd want to stay with you if they are good people and they realize that they want to learn as well. Secondly, when you're investing in training, in learning, etc., if they are paid courses, then obviously companies look at a lockdown period of some amount of time where the person has to work with that company, right? You could apply those strategies to be able to also retain your talent, right? Processify and repeat. Like I said, reuse whatever you have and make sure that anything new you do, there's a process document so that tomorrow when, you know, you're tackling it again, you know exactly how to follow it like clockwork. And you guys, as owners of those companies, as people who run and drive different firms, different agencies, etc., you need to know that you need to focus on larger things and the most important things. For somebody, it might be development. For somebody, it might be just the design that's being applied to websites. For somebody, it might be acquiring clients. Make sure you focus on the right things and have the right people doing the rest. All right? Yeah? So this market might be changing, all right? But I don't think that the importance of web professionals is. I think the importance of web professionals still exists and it will continue to exist, but we just need to adapt. We need to make sure that we're actually moving with the times, right? These are some more SMB insights, right? I can't imagine building a website on my own. So when somebody needs a website, right? How many of you guys agree with that first statement as well? That customers would feel this way? Yeah, y'all think customers can build sites on their own. I can tell you as head of Reseller Club, I can't build a site on my own. I would also come to you guys. I don't know how to do anything online except for surfing and email. Okay, I know a little more than that, but it's true. There are people who find these apps, etc., extremely confusing to use. So they need somebody to handhold them through the process, right? I have a guy who helps me set up email and, you know, users in my HR software. I have a guy who helps me manage all my online tools, right? These are statements being made by customers today, right? Which basically means that these are the kind of guys that are relying on you. And there are many, many of these guys as well. How many of you guys know that, do you remember that I do a few shameless marketing slides towards the end as well? So it's that time of the day when I sort of cover a little bit about Reseller Club. Before I actually move on to this, how many of you guys has, you know, all the information, whatever I've covered so far, how much of that has resonated with you guys? If it's resonated with you guys, could you just show me your hands? All right, cool. Shruti, we've managed to once again at least create a little bit of value and, you know, add some perspective. Thank you, guys. So now very quickly on Reseller Club. Reseller Club loves web professionals. We're doing everything in our, you know, with the ability that we have to actually offer you many more meaningful parts or many more meaningful aspects within your reseller account. So a couple of the experience changes that we've made, we've launched a new Web Pro panel. We've launched a new mobile app. How many of you guys are using the mobile app right now? Perfect. So if you go to the Reseller Club booth, you could actually sign up for both the Web Pro panel and the mobile app. Both of these are available in beta and will be offered to you within a day or two. Some of our products that we've launched this year, we've launched WordPress packages, themes and plugins, WordPress themes and plugins. We're using Mojo Marketplace at the back end for these. We've also launched our new SSD-based VPS, you know, with more panel options, etc. And we've launched the auto NEFT feature as well. How many of you guys had demanded for the auto NEFT feature? Yeah. Okay, you should definitely talk about it on the booth. It's available now. It makes payments way more easier for you know, for all our Indian clients, and there's lesser transaction fee and stuff like that as well. So that last part is actually what excites me the most, making sure that you can pay us a little more easily. Right, so today belongs to you, tomorrow belongs to you, and this is really it, right? We're at that stage where we want to make sure that you can evolve and that you can sort of grow your business and continue growing your business. Reseller Club is not in the business of dealing with SMBs directly. Reseller Club is in the business of empowering you, all right, and making sure that you grow your business. This is not something that we needed to stick to. This is something that we chose to stick to in a market like India, because we know that India runs on its web professionals. Those 3 million websites, I guarantee you, not more than 2 to 3% of those would be made in-house by somebody who's not you or somebody like you, all right? That's the power of this industry, of you guys, right? So just remember one last thing, that Reseller Club loves web pros, all right? This was it. This was my presentation. Before I sort of move on, I, you know, for many years now, I have come and I have spoken to you guys, you know, and hopefully in some capacity or the other, I will always sort of come back and continue speaking to you guys. But today I wanted to take just 2 more minutes to introduce you to the real, how do I put this? Heroes and pillars of Reseller Club, right? So I've asked all of them to wait here, and I'd like to sort of call them on stage one by one. Janki, who basically, you know, runs this entire event for you guys. Janki, please come on stage. Meenal and Varun, who handle strategic partnerships and marketing for Reseller Club as well. Guys, please come over. Simran and Prateek, who are our product managers. Prateek handles all our hosting products. So when something goes wrong, you know who to catch. And Simran, who handles our experience. Guys, please, I told you all to stay closer to stage, no? I don't know how many of you guys have interacted with them, but I'd like to sort of call all of them on stage. I'd like to call Muktadir on stage as well. Muki heads all our client-facing teams, that's sales, account management, and support. Please come, please come. Run, no, or you'll fall again and break your other hand. All right, so this is the team that sort of manages everything. I don't do anything, they do. And I've left one last person to call on to, who actually works with them and pretty much heads the Reseller Club business. She's been the most important pillar for me in the last 5 or 6 years. And I'm proud to say that she is the true business head of Reseller Club. While I come and do these talks, etc., it's actually Shruti who should basically be here along with these guys and sort of take a lot of the credit for everything that Reseller Club does, both good and bad. Yeah, please. See, you knew I was going to call you. You should have just waited somewhere closer, no? Okay, guys, I request you to please give this team a huge round of applause. And a huge round of applause to you guys for bearing with me for so long. Thank you so much. It's been fun, and I hope I can talk to you guys at some point in time again. Thank you.